释迦牟尼佛，释迦牟尼佛，释迦牟尼佛，多娑
婆。Now, to begin the teaching, always the very first thing is to have the right motivation, because whatever practice we do, whatever teachings we receive, where it eventually leads, it depends on one's first motivation. And so therefore, it is very important to have the right motivation. If one has a bad motivation, that with the desire, anger, etc. For example, by receiving this teaching that I will make wealth, which is associated with desire, and by receiving this teaching that I will become very learned, and that I will defeat with the other or compete with the other masters and so on. So which kind of anger and jealousy. So such a if one has such motivation, then it is just like taking the wrong medicine, which is instead of curing your disease, it will cause more harms. And if you don't have a good or bad both motivations, just you come here out of curiosity, out of just to see or as a spectators, also has no use. And if you have good motivation, then even just by hearing one line of teaching has a great benefit. And the good motivation also has different levels. Some people receive teachings just to overcome the obstacles and to gain longevity, wealth, prosperity, etc., which is a good motivation, but it is for the sake of this life. And as in this teaching, the very first thing which says that if you have attachment to this life, one is not a dharmic or the religious person. So although it's a good motivation, but it is a worldly motivation, and it is not a dharma, it is a, what we call the worldly dharma. And then some receive the life is not going to last forever. One day we have to leave, and no one knows what after when we leave this world, where it goes. Ordinary people don't know. Many people even do not believe a life after this. But according to the teachings, although our body will be disposed in one way or another, but the mind cannot be disposed the way body disposed. So the one mind has to enter another life. And at that time, the negative deeds that we have committed will cause to fall down what we call the lower realms. And the virtuous deeds that we have committed will cause to be born in the higher realms. And if one falls in the lower realm, then there's an immense suffering. And nobody wants suffering. Everybody is afraid of suffering. So out of fear for the suffering of lower realms and wish to be continuously born in the higher realm, and this is good motivation, but it is still within, although it's not attached to this life, but it is still attached to the samsara. So it is known as the small person's path. And then some who think that not only the lower realms are full of suffering, but even in higher realms also, there's no certainty. Nothing lasts forever. even you become the Lord of the heavens, but it doesn't last forever. One day it's going to end. So the entire samsara, no matter where you are born, there's not a single spot that is worthy of attachment. And so therefore, the entire one wishes to renounce the entire samsara, whether it's in lower realm or higher realm, and seek nirvana, one's own liberation, permanently free from all forms of suffering, and to gain the everlasting peace. And this is, of course, very good, but it is not the best, so it's called the mediocre person's path. And then, not only the entire samsara is full of sufferings, but as oneself wish to be free from suffering and find the peace, every sentient being, whether you are believer or non-believer, everyone has the same feeling. And we believe in rebirth. This is not the only life we have. We had innumerable lifetimes and innumerable lives also in the future. So therefore, that every sentient being, every single sentient being is actually very closely associated with us and very, very dear to us by becoming father, mother, brothers and sisters and so on. And so it is not right, because they have given us so much. Every time they have become our parents and relatives and so on, they have given us so much love and so much benefit. But due to the change of life, we do not recognize each other. And we see some as our enemy, some as our friends, some as indifferent, but in reality, every single sentient being, including our most hated enemies also, in reality, our very dear mother, dear, very dear brothers and so on. So therefore, it is not right just to seek liberation for oneself alone. So for the sake of all sentient beings to free from suffering and to lead them to the path of happiness, that one seeks enlightenment. And this is the greatest motivation. And so it's called the great person's path. And so we as a Mahayana practitioner, so one should have this motivation. Every practice we do, the ultimate goal is to attain the full enlightenment for the sake of all sentient beings. So one must have this motivation. When you have such a great motivation like this, then all the other things, such as love to overcome the obstacles, to gain a long life, good health, etc., are very minor things. They are automatically accomplished. And this is called what we call non-abiding nirvana, which means free from, not residing on the two extremes. We have two extremes. One extreme is the samsara, which is full of suffering. And another extreme is the nirvana, where there's no suffering, but it is inactive and could not develop your full qualities. And due to this, then you could not also benefit the others so much. So these are the two extremes. So this is the enlightenment is the above both these two extremes. So therefore it's called non-residing, not residing on the two extremes, and above both samsara and nirvana. So it's also known as a great nirvana. So with such a motivation, such great motivation, and then also with the right conduct, physically sitting in a respectful form, and verbally in silence, and mentally with a great interest and joy to receive the precious teachings. And after receiving this teaching, that one will very diligently follow and practice whatever one learns.